3. Glory in His holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. There is always joy in seeking the Lord. Let's now open our hearts as we worship the Lord.
Oh, we thank you, Jesus. Oh, for everything that you do. You are the great and mighty God. And there's no one like you in heaven and on earth. Oh, we give you praise. Sing the splendor of the King. The splendor.
I'm Joshua, and this is our verse of the day. But as always, before we begin, let's have our Bible check. Bible check! So if you don't have your Bibles right now, go get your Bible. And if you have it right now, go open it up in Psalms chapter 105, verse 3. Okay? Now if you're there, it says there, glory in His holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. Now this time, let's recite the verse together. Alright? Alright. Psalms 105 verse 3. Glory in His holy name, let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. Now for the last time. Psalms 105 verse 3. Glory in His holy name, let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. Nice. Now that we are done with the verse, let's move on to our challenge. So our challenge is not that hard. Our challenge is to tag a friend to watch our Destinations program every Mondays to Fridays, 5 p.m. Tag them here in the comment section below. And let them know more about God as well. Alright? Alright. Now, are you up for the challenge? If you're up for the challenge, let's do this. Alright? This is Verse of the Day, and you are destined for Christ.
Hello! Welcome to
Singing in Praise!
Yeah, in this segment, we'll be learning about praise and worship, and it will encourage you more to sing His praise wherever you are, wherever you go. So, for today, we'll be learning about how we are to worship our wonderful God today. Yes, you heard me right. Today, in this so-called new normal, how should we worship our God? Is there any difference? So let's look in the Word of God. It says in Psalm 95 verse 6, "Oh come, let us worship and bow down, let us kneel before the Lord, our Maker." So there's two Hebrew words for you today. Number one is the Hebrew word, kara. And kara means to bow down or to bow in reverence. And the second Hebrew word, you already know this, it starts with letter B. Yes, you're right. Barak. Barak means to kneel or to bless. When we worship God, when we come to worship God, the Word of God is always true. The Word of God never changed. It's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And we see there that the normal for them is to bless God, to kneel down before Him, to worship Him in reverence, in awe. So this is how we still should worship our wonderful God. So even if you're just watching from your home, even if you're just online, you still bow down to Him. You still worship Him in reverence. That's what we do. That is the normal for heavenians. That is the normal for worshipers. So as you sing His praise today, don't forget to add it in your list as you express your worship to Him. Amen.
Sing His praise.
That's it for our
Singing His praise.
You are destined for Christ.
Hi, I'm Pastor Aura Cristel, and welcome back to Teens in Tune. And here I'm going to update you with awesome Christian songs that we can listen to. But before we include our song on our list, we make sure, say it with me, that the lyrics are Bible-based and the singers are solid Christians. Alright, so today our next artists need no further introduction. From the one who gave us the songs, "How Great Is Our God, Good Good Father, Love Run Red," and many more. Do you already have a guess? Yes, you're right, Chris Tomlin. Did you know Chris Tomlin has released a new album and it is entitled Chris Tomlin and Friends? So the song "Who You Are to Me" included in this album is written by himself with a friend called Lady A and Charles, another friend of his. This song talks about one's declaration of who Jesus is for them. Not what other people tells who Jesus is, but own declaration. This declaration flows from our personal relationship, revelation of who Jesus is. It comes by continually seeking Him in our life. It comes by reading your Bible. It comes with your personal communication of with Jesus Christ. It is just like when Jesus Christ asked Peter who He is for him. We can find that in Matthew 16:15-16. But what about you, He asked? Who do you say I am? Simon Peter answered, You are the Messiah, the Son of the Living God. How about you? Who is Jesus to you? When you finally get that revelation, that's when God can move through you, just like Peter. Why don't we try singing that song?
You're amazing, faithful, love's open door. When I'm empty, you fill me with hunger for more of your mercy, your goodness. Lord, you're the air that I breathe. To you are me.
I hope you like that. That is really a good song. And the album is actually really good. I suggest you listen to that too. So, this has been me, Pastora Cristel, saying we should always remember that it is important that we choose the songs that we listen to. Let God's word always be our standard in everything. So, remember, you are destined for Christ. God bless you.
This is your Compass. I'm Pastora Ali. Welcome to Quench Your Thursday. Today, we will be learning about seeking God and finding joy. In Psalms 105 verse 3, glory in His holy name, let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. So who are those people who find joy? People who seek God. First, let's define the word joy here. So rejoice is from the Hebrew word samak, which means to rejoice, to be glad, to brighten up, to be blithe or gleesome, to cheer up, to make joyful, be merry, or cause to rejoice. So when we say that when we seek the Lord, we find joy, we need to understand that God is the source of our joy. It means that God is the only source of joy. So when we talk about joy here, it's not just temporary joy. It's not just joy that will last for like 3 days. This is the kind of joy that God wants to give us. Number one, full joy. In Psalm 16 verse 11, you make known to me the path of life. In your presence, there is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures forevermore. God wants to give you full joy. God wants to give you abundant joy. And if you're overflowing with joy when you seek the Lord, there is no more room for sadness in your heart. There is no room for depression because God will fill your heart with joy, with abundant joy. This is not just temporary joy. This is abundant in your life. It will continue to flow in your life. When you seek God, you will never run out of joy. That's why no matter what's happening right now, you're still happy. You can smile. You can face tomorrow because you know God is with you. Secondly, God wants to give you a joyful heart. Psalm 16 verse 8 to 9, I have set the Lord always before me because He is at my right hand. I shall not be shaken. Therefore, my heart is glad and my whole being rejoices. My flesh also dwells secure. Our heart here refers to our mind. So when the Bible says that our heart will be full of joy, our mind, diba? Every time we think, it's full of joy. There is joy. The joy that God gives us is something that will affect our minds as well, the way we think. We don't think of sad things always. We don't think of negative things. There is joy in our minds, in our hearts, when we seek the Lord. It can be... It will not be filled with worries. It will be filled with joy. Next, your whole being will be joyful. Psalm 16 verse 8 to 9, I have set the Lord always before me because He is at my right hand. I shall not be shaken. Therefore, my heart is glad and my whole being rejoices. My flesh also dwells secure. So our flesh here refers to our body, our whole being. It refers to yourself. When God gives you joy, it radiates in you. It can be seen in you. It can be seen in your face. It can be seen in your people can see that joy. It radiates in you. There is joy that can be seen in your life. It radiates in you. The joy that God gives us when we seek Him is the kind of joy that other people can see as well, because our whole body rejoices. So now, lastly, God wants to give you a joy that is confident. Psalm 16 verse 8 to 9, I have set the Lord always before me, because He is at my right hand. I shall not be shaken. Therefore, my heart is glad and my whole being rejoices. My flesh also dwells secure. Security. There is confidence. There is no insecurity in the joy that God gives us. When we seek Him, we find joy with confidence. With confidence that we can face every day, no matter what the circumstances are. There is no insecurity that if we're so happy right now, what will happen tomorrow? We might be sad. You know people who think like that? There is no room for that in our lives. Because when we seek the Lord, He gives us this kind of joy. A joy with confidence and security of the days to come. So teens, remember to seek the Lord. Remember to seek Him with all your heart, and surely you will be filled with joy in abundance, with confidence, with a joyful heart. You will never be scared whatever might happen, because you know God is with you. Why don't we all pray together? Father, I lift up to you our teens, and we thank you in Jesus' name, because you will be the source of their joy. They will not find joy in any other things of this world. They can only find true joy in you. And this joy will be so abundant in their lives that they will be filled each day with hope, with confidence, because you will fill them with joy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. So teens, thank you for being here today. This is Compass. I'm Pastora Ali. You are destined for Christ. See you tomorrow.